Good morning, guys. It is a new day, a new vlog. So the shower's going on in the background, obviously, but I have a very exciting day planned today. So today is the grand opening of the Melrose Trading Post. For those of you guys who don't know what it is, essentially in LA you have like this huge, like a swap meet market, flea market type, but it's kind of like super like dressed up and edgy and elegant. And so today we're gonna be heading up to LA to go and check that out. Like I said, it's the grand opening to kind of go and just make a day out of it up in LA. I'm so excited. I haven't literally been in so long. That is the plan for right now. I just woke up, clearly. Outfit of the day right now. I'm about to do my hair, do my makeup, get dressed, and then we're gonna try to head out on the road as soon as possible, just so we can get up there pretty fast. And yeah, so I'm gonna get ready and then I will check back in with you guys in a little bit. Hey guys, so obviously it's a little bit later in the day. I'm officially dressed, have my makeup on. I'm trying out this new oat milk based foundation that I'm super excited about. I just found it the other day and so I feel like it's perfect for my skin combo just because I have super sensitive skin, and so this is like vegan, no parabens, no like added preservatives or anything, so it's really good. Wow, the road is so bumpy. But now we're just in the car driving up to LA right now. I officially had my last day of work last week, so I just wanted to kind of kick off August on a really happy and just like relaxing note. So like I mentioned before, it's the grand opening of the Melrose Trading Post. I feel like it'll just be so fun to take you guys along. I've been wanting to go there for ages, but because of everything that's going on, obviously they had to close down. Sorry, my arm's like going up and down because this road is terrible. We're on the toll road right now. But while we're up in LA, there are a few other areas where I kind of want to go and just like explore, and a few little spots that I've been just dying to kind of hit. So I feel like this will just be like a really fun vlog to kind of take you guys with me on my day today. And also, I hope that this can kind of give you guys some ideas if you're ever in the area, or if you ever kind of want suggestions as to where to go in LA. I hope this also kind of acts as a guide, because I've like struggled in the past where I've like frantically searched like blogger's guide to Los Angeles or to Newport or Palm Springs. So I always love kind of watching these little travel vlogs, and so I kind of wanted to make one for you guys. We're just gonna continue driving up to LA. We're sort of almost there, and then I will check back in with you guys once we get there. So we just got here and now we are in line to go in. Here's a cute outfit of the day. And we're about to get an entrance fee right now. Or pay the entrance fee, and then we're gonna go in and just kind of walk around. They have the year necklaces, Mom.
I have them in stainless steel also.
Now we're all here. Eva's right there.
Here. This is Melrose. Oh, Jonathan Adler. Oh, so
your old
cool.
Your old job.
I know, I used to do comedy at the LA Improv. we are now driving down Melrose Avenue, and here's Paul Smith, the pink wall, and then Carrera Cafe. So there's Reformation. Oh, that's cute. Do you want to go in?
I think they were closed.
No, they're open, the Sweet Spark. So we just saw a really cute little boutique. So I think we're going to go in there. And then after that, if you want, we can go get coffee, Olivia Westwood. That little place up there.
That we can park right next to it then.
Or, you know, just park here, because then I can go into Vivian Westwood. Also, we just found Crossroads. A Vivian Westwood. Didn't know there was one down here.
It's Crossroads.
Good news as always. What's Crossroads?
Apparently.
Have you heard good stuff about it?
Yeah.
Two cases over here that are also vintage. And this is
so
vintage.
I'm so obsessed
you know
with
what
this.
You can do?
So cute, wait, turn. That's like the perfect size for you. That's really cute. So right now we're just walking to my favorite coffee place in LA called Alfred's Tea, and it's literally so adorable. It's total PF Cheagles. Okay, we're open. Please pick from our courtyard. Okay, so this is what it looks like essentially. So adorable. So now we're just gonna go around to the other side to go and grab some drinks. So we just had to place our orders through the app right now because I guess the facilities closed down just because of quarantine and everything. So we just placed our order over here and then we're gonna go and pick it up. And should be nice. Really excited to finally get this. So I ordered their chaga cold brew with extra ice. And we ordered two of their vegan tea scones just because they're probably so good. So I'm really excited for that. Doesn't this look so good? Chaga cold brew. Oh my god, yes. Just got the chaga cold brew. It is honestly the best coffee drink that I've ever had. Do you like yours?
Yeah.
But it's so hot out. She got the golden turmeric.
Should have had more, should have got sweeter, but.
But so good. Oh my god. But like I said, it's literally so hot out, so like everyone's indoors. So we might just go and like enjoy this in the car, honestly, with the AC because it is literally so hot out. So we left Alfred's and so now we're at this really cool outdoor like shopping center and like a little like marketplace called The Grove in LA. So we have our goods and now we're just gonna go walk around a little bit. It's really nice and I feel like more stuff is probably open here just because a lot was kind of just like closed on Melrose. So now we're just gonna walk around a little bit, browse, and then it's a little bit later in the afternoon. It's like 4:30, I think. And so I definitely wanna go hit a few stores while we're here though. Like the Zara is way better up here, so that's what we're gonna do. So that's kind of the plan for right now. This is such a cute marketplace. Years ago, we used to come here because they also have an American Doll here. Remember American Doll? And I was literally obsessed with American Doll. And so all of my best friends and I would come up and we would like make a day out of it. And they have like a Dylan's candy bar too. But one year we were up here and we saw like a ton of people from The Bachelor. And obviously when you're like little and you watch it, you like idolize them. And that was like the highlight of my life growing up. And so now whenever I come, like I'm so adamant about just like people watching and see if like I can find anybody famous. And it's literally so fun. Here is the famous Dylan's candy bar. I kind of want to get something before we leave. Right across over there is American Girl. literally obsessed. We used to eat dinner here after the Marmalade Cafe, and so now we are just going to walk around a little bit and do some shopping. I've been waiting for Aloe in all its glory with all things Aloe. They have these Bala bangles. I've literally been looking for them like everywhere. Yeah, no, these are the Bala ones. And they're sold out everywhere on back order. And then they also have them in pink too. And I'm like torn between the colors. It's so heavy. So now we're just walking around. Just left Aloe, and honestly I decided to splurge on a yoga mat just because I've been wanting one for a while and I just really wanted to up my practice. So right now we're just kind of making the loop. Doesn't it feel like we're at Disneyland?
Yeah, I want to go to sushi.
I mean, I'm not hungry now. But it's so nice out. I have to show you guys this view because, like I said, it literally feels like we're at Disneyland, and it's just so beautiful out today. This is the view. And we just came from down there and walked around, and then they have like a little center plaza. And so we're just gonna keep walking around. It's right across the way. Hold on, my thing just fell. Okay, gotta readjust my yoga mat, but I'll check in with you guys later. Looks so good. Hey guys, so clearly it is the next day. We got home pretty late last night, so I just figured that I would wait until this morning to finish off the vlog for you guys. So obviously I'm still in my pajamas right now. I just put on like a tiny bit of makeup just to kind of get me through the day, and I hopped out of the shower so my hair is up right now. But yeah, so Los Angeles was so fun. We ended up going to the Melrose Trading Post, which it was a lot less crowded than I expected, but at the same time it was so nice because I feel like whenever we would go in the past it was always just too crowded, and then it would kind of get stressful, like especially being able to kind of like pick up on other people's energies and stuff. So it was a lot more laid back, which was really nice, but also there weren't that many vendors, which also I feel like it's good and bad. They have this main one that I always go to for jewelry. So like they were there and I was really happy. They didn't have their food section. There were a few vendors that I had been looking for that I wasn't able to find. So that was kind of a bummer. But then again, like it was kind of nice just being able to sort of take our time and go through everything. So that was really fun. And then we just kind of, like you saw, just like drove around Melrose, went into a few really cute boutiques, and then grabbed coffee at Alfred Tea and Coffee House, which literally is my favorite. I got the chaga cold brew with almond milk, and that's literally like my new favorite drink in the world. It's gonna be so hard to find something that's that good down here in San Diego. So that was really fun too. And then after that we literally just went to the Grove, which is really nice too. I inserted some footage, but I didn't realize, because I'd heard before that Topshop had closed in the US, and I'm not even sure if they have like an online store, but I know that they're still, I think, I want to say like in Canada and Europe, but they have a Topshop at the Grove. So I walked in and I started kind of filming because obviously I wanted to incorporate it into the vlog. And I immediately got yelled at because I guess we're not allowed to film in there just because it turns out that it's the only Topshop in the US. So that was pretty special to kind of be in there. Like I said, I will insert, or I would have inserted, the few seconds of video that I was able to get in there. I just think it was so cool. Like, I understand that they have stuff online, but I'm the type of person where I really just kind of need to try it on and feel the articles of clothing in person. But the main reason why I wanted to go to the Grove, and I sort of talked about this before, is more of just like a homey feeling in a sense. And it's not that the shopping mall itself is like really important to me, but the fact that I used to go there all the time growing up because they have this huge American Doll store there. And so all my friends and I would go there and make a day out of it and either spend the night in Los Angeles growing up or just go there, and then we'd go to Dylan's Candy Bar afterwards. And so they had like the American Girl Cafe, and it was just a major throwback that just really hit close to home. So it's always a joy going there. I have so many of my childhood memories that have to do with American Doll, so that was just a big chunk of my life. And like, even growing up, for my 5th birthday, we rented a limo and took all my friends up to Los Angeles to go to American Doll, which is where I got my first doll. So that's just something special that I kind of always get to hold on to. They have this awesome like grocery food section, and they had like this huge French marché, so they had like a ton of imported stuff, and I was literally in heaven because obviously my friends know that I'm so obsessed with like grocery stores, especially having lived in New York for so long, just because they have the coolest stuff there. And then I ended up working at our local health food store, which I no longer do, but obviously like I love doing that. But essentially it was just so nice being able to walk around. Oh, and also I'm so happy because they have an aloe sanctuary, and so they're building one down here closer to San Diego at UTC Mall, but that's been under construction for probably like almost 2 years now. And like I said before, I like to be able to physically try on the clothing and stuff. So I definitely wanted to go and hit Aloe at the Grove, which we did. And I'm really happy. I'll show you guys what I picked up in a few moments. I've been really just trying to get into yoga and just really focus on mindful breathing and just like a healthier lifestyle. So that's what I've been doing. Especially like really small, short meditation sessions at night just to kind of calm myself. So actually I want to try to do one after this just to kind of get into the swing of things. And I had previously purchased a mat at Target, and it was good for the first month, but then after that, like, obviously it's not the best quality. It wasn't expensive, so it's not that big of a deal. I didn't expect it to be that great of a quality. But when I was in New York, I just wanted something super fast, super easy, super simple. So I ended up buying one from Target. But then it kind of started to rip, and I just knew that I needed to invest in a just a nicer yoga mat so I could feel good about my practice. So when we were up there, I'd been eyeing this one aloe yoga mat online. I've been eyeing it for so long, honestly, and I've just been so chicken to get it because, yes, I know that it's really pricey for a yoga mat. That being said, I think that, and my mom always tells me this, is that you have to sort of prioritize what you want in life. So it's like, yes, I could go and spend X amount of money on a yoga mat, or I could go and spend it on something else, and I just had to pick and choose. So I finally caved in. It was so nice. They are sold out all online anyway, so I wouldn't have been able to get it anywhere else. So I decided to splurge on that yoga mat, and I'm so happy I did. And also, I've been looking high and low for Bala bangles. If you guys haven't heard of them, I will show you guys in a second, but they're literally the best invention ever. I actually got mine years ago when I was in high school, probably like 2.5-3 years ago, and lo and behold, they're still in my storage. And so I went to order some like a month and a half ago, and they've been sold out everywhere. They're on back order until like August and September. And so they had ball of bangles there. They had a few left. So they had them in like a nude color, which I already have. They have a pink, a white, and they had one more gray, which is actually the color I'd been wanting. So I also got a pair of the gray ball of bangles as well. And then we went into like Charlotte Tilbury. They have La Durée Café. So it's just like a really nice area, and it's like perfect for people watching too. And so yeah, so that's what we did. And then we decided to drive home. And then I ate dinner here, and then I just kind of relaxed, and then we stayed up until like 2:30 watching Kissing Booth 3 and then the beginning of Kissing Booth 1 again. So with that, that sort of concludes the vlog for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I feel like these types of videos are my most fun ones, and they're just the most fun to film. So I always love like a good excuse to film a travel vlog for you guys. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions, comments, concerns, obviously. And if you haven't already, please hit the like and subscribe button to this channel. And if you haven't already, feel free to check me out on Instagram at anythingbutnaked, where I post on a way more regular basis. That being said, stay tuned for more vids coming your way, and I will see you guys soon.